And best of luck if, like me, you've got something, even if it's old in your life, you value it above anything else that you may have. You could trade it in for something newer or younger.
You reckon, do you?
But you don't. You say, no,
you hang on to it for sentimental reasons.
I'll hang on to it. It's got character. It's got lines in it. It's, you know what I mean. You know what I mean.
It's lovely today.
Why not talk?
Well,
I'm just talking about her.
It's double entendre, though, isn't it?
Well, incidentally, I went into the garage the other day and piled up as all my Manchester United monopolies. I went into the garage yesterday and they were all gone.
Yeah, we'll have a bit of dandruff.
And
if you've bought them from the charity shop, enjoy.
I can't believe that.
So how many Man United Monopoly sets can a man use?
Different players, different ages, different stages. I just can't.
I should have brought them in for Lauren to value.
Well, I know
I
you love
that.
Christmas. So.
I do.
Anyway,
we've got lots of our viewers who are always sending letters in saying, I've got something that I think might be valuable, sentimental reasons. So we've got three of them in today to show Lauren their treasures. We've got Nina Hunt from Kennington Furs. In you come, Nina, very gingerly stepping over our cables there. Because you've got this glass vase. Come and stand here with me, Nina. So this belonged to your mum, I believe, didn't
it? Yes, it is. She bought it in a flea market in Hemel Hempstead in the 50s. About 10 shillings, I think.
10 shillings, OK. And what do you know about it? Have you tried to find out anything about it?
Well, it's got 1913 written on it, so that was a big clue. But it's got signatures on it that I can't understand what they are. And I think it's Scandinavian.
So your mother bought
it valued
for...
Yes, I took it about 10 years ago. I took it to be valued and... they didn't know who the people were at the bottom. They said that it was unique, but about
£100.
And mum spent 50p in the first place.
Well,
I think you're going to make a profit. I think it's definitely French. It very much looks like Alique because Alique do a lot of fish smoked glass ornaments. And it's Edwardian. It's very, very nice. Valuation-wise, it's about £300. I've seen it. It's beautiful.
And it looks in very good condition.
Yeah, it's in very good condition. And it will only go up in value in the future.
Mm. Oh, excellent.
Now, Nina, it is the same colour as your outfit today. It obviously matches in around the home. Is it something you would be tempted to part with for a bit of cash?
Not unless it was worth thousands and it would pay off my mortgage. But,
okay. But it's not. But if
I hang on to it.
If you hang on to any antiques, they always got from value.
Help my children.
Okay. Yeah, give it to your children. That would be nice.
And do you use this in day-to-day life? Do you put flowers
on the mantelpiece.
Do you always put flowers in a vase? They're wasted otherwise.
Yes. Okay.
Well, there you are. Thank you
very
much indeed for that.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Nice bit of stuff. Thank you.
Next, we've got Teresa Brett. Come in, Teresa. Now, this is very interesting. This is the lovely
green China dog.
But I was going to say, Lauren, I know, has already had a look at this and she's likes it.
Yeah.
Let's get you to tell us first about it. Come stand next to me. Tell us where this is from, how it came into your household.
It was bought from a local antique house in Southend. My mum loved dogs, and our surname being Brett, she saw a piece of Brett B and decided it was for her.
What is Brett B?
Preppy is a very collectible china, British china, but you were told it was reproduction.
I was told that there was a possibility that it could be, yes.
But if you look at the bottom, I'm actually going to pick it up and show the camera, yes. If you see the bottom, it's got a little moon top, which proves it's real. Oh. And I love dogs. I think everybody loves dogs, and I'm a dog lover. And especially when you only have one with one eye.
It's not the prettiest.
Oh, I love it. I think it's just beautiful.
It's not the prettiest dog.
Because he's so ugly, he's adorable.
No, sometimes dogs, but it's just I love dogs, and I would have that. I would take that off you now.
But before we get Lauren to value it, if it was worth a lot of money or not, would you ever sell it?
No.
How much sentimental value does it have for you?
Everything, because I lost my mum last year.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry about that.
So that's, no, it's fine.
So that's very special to
yes,
you.
Yes, extremely.
Okay, so A, we know it is a real Brett B.
It is real Brett B.
So how much would that be worth?
Well, I have been generous because I love dogs and I love this, and Brett B will got value as well as all antiques, and I valued it at £350. And I really admire the piece tremendously.
Yes.
And it's got magic. And when I see something like that, I get a little bit excited.
And can you remember how much your mum paid for it?
With auction premium, £60.
Well, she's had an eye for a bargain.
But this was the last thing she bought, wasn't it?
At auction, yes.
So it must be a real memory for you.
Well, listen, very special. Take very good care of that.
That's lovely.
There you go, doggy.
Thank you. Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.
Thank you. Teresa is from Stanford La Hope, so thank you for that. We have finally got a teapot and a biscuit barrel, and it's from Sandra Cullop, and Sandra's from Carshalton in Surrey. Very good to see
you. They look interesting. A matching biscuit barrel.
Anything in your biscuit barrel?
No, sorry.
So tell us about these, Sandra.
My parents acquired them from an old lady in Croydon. They used to rent the upstairs of her apartment. My mum used to cook her meals, and my dad decorated the house, and she just gave them to as a gift.
So she'd said to them, didn't she, take something from the house that
you'd like? Yeah, she did, but she said, I'd like to give you these. So that was like 57 years ago, and I lost my mum in 2009, and my dad's had them in just a cabinet.
Did they ever use them?
No, always been in the cabinet.
And do you know anything else about their
value? We tried to find out, and we just couldn't find out anything. So.
Well, that's why I'm here.
There you are. You can really know all about
it. Well, actually, they're not a pair. They're actually individual pieces. Mm-hmm. Now, I have to pick them up. Oh, am I going to smash them? I hope not. Now, this one is 1920s because it's got the red mark made in Japan. And this one is the 1940s. They're separate pieces and they are really very nice. But Satsuma Ware made a lot of this. A lot of this China
What's
ware.
What's it called?
Satsuma ware.
Satsuma.
Almost just think of the little orange and you'll remember, because there's a lot of orange in the picture, in the ornaments. And the thing is, unfortunately, I've given it a valuation of £70, but for the pair, as I told you, though, they will go up in value. Satsuma ware made some tremendous, amazing china, but this was very, very popular. And it's something you can still get today, so it's not rare enough.
So there was a lot of it.
Yeah. It's not rare enough to be worth a lot. Mm-hmm. But it's sentimental anyway, isn't it, for you?
Yeah. But if Sandra keeps it, she said her dad hadn't, they hadn't used it.
Oh, no, old. Yeah. It's old, and old pieces will. And as I said, if you put that in a modern house, it would set it off because it's very chic.
Right. I'll have a bit of Earl Grey and a custard cream.
You can fix I'd have English breakfast.
All right,
happy
English breakfast.
Thank you. Yes, lovely.
Sandra, lovely seeing you.
More about them now.
Thank you.
Thank you very much indeed. And Lauren, thank you.
Thank you very much. It's nice to meet you both, and you're so jolly and happy today, which is wonderful.
Thank you very much.
Story of my life, Anna. Thank you very much.
Mind my wisdom teeth.
Oh, my goodness, I didn't know.
I had a wisdom teeth out this week.
Right, so I shall go.
Don't want to give me a valuation here, do you?
There's no money you could put on a lady like this.
Priceless.
Thank you, Lauren.
Thank you very much.
And we've got music. Priceless wife, let's take a break.
Yeah, we've got music at the end of the show. Do you remember Janet Defford's Mex Factor?